Hey guys, so in this video I'm going to show you guys how to make char cloth using just a basic tin, like an Altoids tin, which is what I'm using here. I pierced a little hole in it so the gases escape. Just grabbing a random piece of denim, like old jeans or something, I just cut it into a little square, which I'm going to cut these into smaller squares. And then I have some split wood and sticks that we're going to get the fire going. So for the purpose of char cloth, I'm going to use the char cloth to start a fire here with flint and steel. Got a nice piece of char cloth there. Just gonna rip it in half. In the flint and steel video, I'm just gonna grab one of my little sharp pieces of chert here. A little closer so you guys can see it. You line up the edges, get a spark. There we go, first try. So usually like to do is like to roll it on itself, give it some air so it gets more points of contact. Then I'm gonna put it in my tinder bundle, which is, I have pine leaves. Right here, I'm just gonna kind of tuck it in there a little more. Close it on itself. All right, we got fire. Gonna slowly dump it in here. Let all those pine leaves catch. Again, I just have excess wood that I had laying around, so I'm just going to throw some of that in there and get that to catch some twigs. There's no wind right now and everything's wet, so it's going to be quite a bit of smoke before we get big flames going here, so this might take a little bit. Ooh, mosquitoes are bad. Sometimes when this stuff is dry, it is absolutely a lot quicker, but we'll work with it. Basically, sorry for the quietness. Gosh, mosquito's bad. Basically, we're gonna get this nice and hot. Cut pieces of this denim up. We're gonna put it in the Altoids can and we're gonna set it on top of the fire and get this denim nice and hot. And what it's gonna do, it's gonna turn this into complete carbon, which is essentially char cloth. It's gonna take all the impurities and everything out of it and just make pure carbon. Here we got a little bit of fire going. Put some more of these little sticks in there. just gonna load it up. We get a really nice hot fire, some hot coals, some hot flames. Throw some more twigs on top and I'll start cutting up the denim. We're already at 5 minutes. I was hoping to get this done a lot sooner. Alright, so I'm gonna take the denim cloth. Let me move this side so you can see it. Just gonna pretty much cut it in half and then cut it in small squares. Pretty much small squares like that. And I can make a lot more. You can put double this, if not triple this, in the Altoids can, but I'm gonna put this in there for right now from what I used up today. Those coals almost went in my whole box of tar cloth. Alright, so after you get your fire nice and hot, I'm gonna kind of just build a base. You don't have to do this, but just for the tin to sit on top of. Woo! Alright, so I'm just gonna set the tin right on top. Pretty much, you're just gonna let that sit there so that denim gets really hot, or your tar cloth gets really hot. It's gonna expel a lot of those flammable gases. So at first you're gonna see a little bit of smoke coming out, and then eventually that flammable gas will come out, and that will actually catch on fire from where the hole is. After that all burns off and the smoke stops, then that's when you pretty much wanna take it out, let it cool. I usually flip the tin upside down on the table and put a rock on it, that way it keeps oxygen from getting in. So we'll let that sit and then I'll bring you back. Alright, so it's really hard to see. I'm going to take this off the mount here and show you guys. It's still hard to see. It's such a hot fire, but that tin can right in the middle, you can kind of see it. The flame's coming from the tin can. So that's all those gases burning off. Again, we'll let it sit there for probably about another 5 or 10 minutes. Alright, so that fire went down quite a bit. I'm taking this tin can out. It's only been probably 4 or 5 minutes since I last turned the camera off. I'm just going to take a rock and just set it on top. You can also take this stick and just shove it in that hole and keep oxygen from going in there. But you're just going to let it sit like that for, I don't know, 3 or 4 minutes until it cools off. And then once it's cool to the touch, then I'll open it up and show you guys what's inside. All right, so it's been about 5 minutes, so the tin is pretty cool. Still slightly warm, but it's definitely cool to the touch. So again, I had that hole sitting on the table and then a rock on top just to suffocate it and keep oxygen from getting in. It, like I said, you can make a lot more than this. I just did it just for the video, but as you can see, it's perfect char cloth. And so we'll use this piece. Again, I'm gonna rip it in half. Put it on the edge of my shirt. I wanna show you guys this shirt again one more time. I found this whole rock down by the creek. This is actually only half of it. I don't know where the other half went, but I pretty much just broke off little flakes. I don't know, I just got really lucky. The kids and the girl and I, we went down to the creek and I don't know, I just found that whole nodule, so I mean it throws off some pretty good sparks. I don't know how much it's showing there on video, but it's definitely spark worthy. that piece of char cloth that we just made, I'm putting that right on the edge right there. I thought I was gonna get it in one, but we got it in two. So you can see right there. Perfect, perfect char cloth. All right, guys, well, there you have it. I'm gonna go ahead and put this out. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. I'd be happy to answer them or even learn a thing or two. Like I said, I'm fairly new to this, but I've been interested in it for a long time. This is what I love to do on a daily basis. It's like a hobby. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below and let me know what you guys think of it. And if you guys have any other ways of making char cloth. But that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. Catch you in the next one.